Chico and the Man will not be presented this evening, and the Rockford Files will be seen 1 hour later than normal, so that we may bring you the following special program.
From the scenic shores of majestic Lake Tahoe, it's the Bob Hope All-Star Comedy Spectacular.
Cherokee Nation in terrible trouble, completely surrounded by white eyes and long knives. Must get help from Geronimo. I send him signal now.
Hi, this Geronimo. I'm not in teepee now, but if you leave name and number after the beep, I'd be glad to call you back.
Just my luck. Radio Shack open store in Apache Nation.
Hark! I hear something.
Yeah, must be the sheriff from Nottingham. I'll make short shrift of those rapscallions.
My hero! Hurry, let's open it.
Huh? Leotards, hairspray, dippity-doo, and pantyhose.
Robin, you shot one of your own men.
Rum luck.
Now look here, Scarlet. I'm leaving Lake Tahoe now, and I'm skiing down to the Civil War. But before I go, I want to hear once more, my darling, the golden tone voice of the loveliest belle of the Deep South.
Sí, mi corazón. Tú sabes lo mucho que yo te quiero y siempre te quiero. Solo la muerte nos separará. Lo oyes bien hasta el día que me muera.
I've heard southern accents, but never that far south.
Well, it's the last time I take a golf lesson from Jerry Ford. I want to tell you that.
Sybil.
Derek!
Sybil.
Derek.
Our last night in Tahoe.
This is a holiday I shall never forget. 7 days, 6 nights, 4 shows, 3 complimentary breakfasts, and San Butera and the witnesses.
Oh, it's been divine here in Tahoe. Well, why must it end? After all, I'm a title man. I'm the Earl of Doberman and the Duke of Bath. And you know how hard it is to give a Doberman a bath.
I must go, and you mustn't stop me. But for now, kiss me as if there were no tomorrow.
Oh, yes. But, darling, what about the chauffeur?
All right.
Hey, I suppose you know, Livermore, this is coming out of your wages.
He can kiss her and give her the brush off at the same time.
Livermore, don't make a lunch out of it, you fool.
From beautiful Lake Tahoe, it's Bob Hope's All-Star Comedy Spectacular with Anne Margaret, Charo, Mac Davis, Sammy Davis Jr., Dean Martin, Super Bowl quarterbacks Ken Stabler and Fran Tarkenton, with cameo appearances by Muhammad Ali, Red Buttons, Howard Cosell, Les Brown and his band of renown, and the Lake Tahoe Tacky Film Festival, brought to you by Texaco. We invite you to visit your independent Texaco retailer, who has quality gasoline for your car and can help keep it running in top shape with fine quality Texaco products. And now, Texaco is proud to present Bob Hope's All-Star Comedy Spectacular. From the beautiful South Shore Room of Harrah's in Lake Tahoe, here's the star of our show, Bob Hope.
Thank you.
Hey. Thank you. It helps when you're in free, huh? Ladies and gentlemen, here we are in Tahoe, Lake Tahoe, the winter wonderland of the West, the home of skiing. Thank you, natives. The home of ski and snow and 10 below. Tahoe is, that's Las Vegas with thermal underwear. Tahoe is really beautiful. They intend to keep it that way. They have one guy who does nothing but shoo the pigeons toward Reno. And when we landed at the airport, it was snowing real hard. But luckily, Bill Harry had a limousine right there waiting for me. Well, not a limousine exactly. It was a snowmobile. No, it wasn't really a snowmobile. It was a ski pole and a pair of galoshes. But you could tell this is a winter resort. When the doorman held his hot hand out, he didn't want a tip. He just wanted me to blow on his fingers. I tell you, the air here is so clean, when I got off the plane from Los Angeles, I fainted. They had to give me mouth-to-mouth resuscitation from the tailpipe of a cab. It is beautiful. It's so beautiful. The air here is so pure, it's a great feeling to breathe without chewing. My lungs enjoyed it so much, they wanted to know if it was legal. I don't know why they call this mountain air bracing. Los Angeles smog is far more bracing. You can lean against it. And this place is loaded. It's so beautiful with beautiful pine trees. You could bring your dog here and he'd never have time to bark. Boy, what a football season, though. The Cotton Bowl, the Super Bowl, and they got a new one now, the Coffee Bowl. That's the one where you watch Joe DiMaggio and Mrs. Olson fight it out over a pound of U-Ban. Hey! How about the price of coffee zooming to $3 a pound? You remember when the caffeine used to keep you awake? Now it's the prices. No, coffee comes in three types now: instant, regular, and negotiable. No, we're really in trouble. The Arabs have us over a barrel, and the Brazilians have us over a pot. Coffee is so expensive right now, to make it last, people don't brew it anymore. They roll it in a zigzag paper and smoke it. No, they figure as long as the price is so high, they might as well get a little high themselves, you know? Hey, and we have a new cabin at the White House now. After a lengthy search, President Carter managed to locate a dozen people who can smile while they're eating grits. And let me tell you, he had a tough job. 2,000 jobs to fill and only 32 relatives. Let me tell you, Jimmy Carter just picked two women for his cabinet, and Rosalind okayed them. She made sure they can type. And for national security advisor, Carter picked Zbigniew Brzezinski. Quite a name, isn't it? I wonder what it was before he changed it. Zbigniew Brzezinski. Say it fast, you'll never have to buy a water pick. You know that Amy is nagging her father for a government job? He can't seem to convince her we don't have an ambassador to Disneyland. And she's going to public school. Isn't that a wonderful thing? And if she likes it, they're going to let the other kids come back. Hey, and how about the inaugural, huh? Yesterday was the big day. Last night, Jimmy Carter officially changed his address from Plains, Georgia, to Down the Road a Piece. Did you see the size of that crowd? The president said, y'all come, and they did. And what a turnout. The Democrats came to Washington any way they could. They were riding trains, buses, bicycles, Republicans.
Washington was packed solid. The crowd was so big, one guy picked his own pocket 12 times. Did you see, Carter was sworn in by Chief Justice Burger. That was the first time he'd ever taken an oath from a Republican without swearing back. Now, the swearing-in ceremony was right out in the open. The Democrats applauded Jimmy Carter, and the Republicans applauded the pigeons. Everyone thinks I didn't receive an invitation to the inaugural. Well, I did. Of course, it was covered with Melvin Dumar's fingerprints. Actually, I didn't receive an invitation. The most exciting thing I've received in the mail this month is a notice that I may have won the Reader's Digest sweepstakes. I had hoped to be invited to the inaugural ball myself, you know, and I thought I had a sure way of getting in good with the new administration. I was going to go to the inaugural ball in a pickup truck, but I made one mistake. It was a Ford pickup truck. You notice the inaugural had a southern flavor? It's the first time I ever heard Hail to the Chief played on the jug and wash bucket. And they're going to open some new congressional investigations, like who gave the match to Sherman when he went through Georgia. And they're changing the finish of Gone with the Wind now. In the new version, Grand Rapids burns. Southern accents are going to take over the nation. And I was just catching on to the CB lingo. And you know a person from the South when he complains about Jimmy Stewart talking too fast. Hey, and how about that congratulatory telegram the Russian government sent Carter? Jimmy knew Brezhnev was sincere. All it said was, "Trust me." No, Russia's trying to get on Carter's good side. They've ordered their restaurants to serve peanut borscht and grits a la Romanov. Now, who can blame Russia for wanting to be friends with Carter? They have all our bread, but what good is it without peanut butter? Who owns America's oil companies? You could be in for a surprise. Hey, this is Bob Hope, and I'd like to show you how some of the owners of America's oil companies live. If a lot of them look very much like people, you know, it isn't surprising. They're Texaco stockholders, who, along with more than 2 million other Americans, are investing in America's oil industry. In six companies alone, over half of them are women. Almost half are retired. Another 12 million Americans have invested through organizations which invest their money for them, such as mutual funds. Over 90 colleges and universities depend on part of their income from investments in oil companies. So do about 1,000 charitable and educational institutions. Who owns America's oil companies? Over 14 million Americans, some 370,000 of them with Texaco alone. That's a lot of people who put their trust in companies like Texaco. And we're working to keep that trust. How do I introduce my next guest? To say he's a great singer or dancer or dynamic entertainer is something you already know. So I'll just sum it up in three words: Sammy Davis Jr.
Gone, love is never gone, as we travel on, love's what we'll remember. Kiss the day goodbye, the sweetness and the sorrow. We did what we had to do, and I can't regret what I did for love, what I did for love. Look, my eyes are dry. The gift was ours to borrow. It's as if we always knew, but I won't forget what I did for love, what I did for love. Gone, love was never gone, as we travel on, love's what we'll remember. Kiss the day goodbye, then point me toward tomorrow. Wish me luck, the same to you. Won't forget, can't regret what I did for love. Won't forget, can't regret what I did.
Oh, wow. Here I am, a giant superstar on the big night of the Grammy Awards. I am so fabulous and talented and beautiful. I've been nominated in five categories. Rock, country, blues, jazz, and humility. And why shouldn't I be? I paid my dues, oh yes. I worked every disco dive in every Fleabag hotel in every tank town in America. It was the worst 4 days of my life. And now I'm right on top. Oh, yes, the gold records are all over my walls. I've got a maid, a chauffeur, and a has-been husband. What more could a superstar want? And all because of my first gold record. Breaker, breaker of my heart, this is 10-4, we must part. I'm hitching my rig to another star. I get the kids and the house in the car. That must be my has-been husband now.
That's the last time I buy formal wear from Columbo. Busted flag from Toluca Lake, hit by truck and bit by a snake, kicked in the teeth in Santa Fe. And Tuesday week, I passed away. That's why they call me Lucky McGee.
write songs like that anymore.
They wouldn't dare.
We found this bum in the gutter, ma'am.
That's not the gutter, that's his room.
Yeah, didn't you notice the monogram napkins in my teddy bear?
Oh, thanks, officers. Here's a couple of gold records for your trouble.
Much obliged.
Police brutality.
Look at you. Once you were the biggest rock star in the world, and now you're a beaten, decrepit shell of a man. You are disgusting and despicable.
Yeah. How do you think I feel? I used to be on top. I had a mansion in Beverly Hills with a view of the Pacific and the Atlantic. I had a Rolls Royce with four on the floor. The Pointer Sisters. Now I can't even get the Disco Duck on the phone.
Oh, my poor, sweet, lovable, precious creep.
What happened? I was going pretty good there for a while.
4 out of 5 ain't bad.
Baby, what's become of us? What's become of us?
Oh, you'll be on top again. You'll see, darling.
Are you kidding? Look at my albums. They used to sell by the millions. Now I can't even give them away. They're coming back faster. See what I mean, baby? It's over. I can't go on living. I can't.
No, no, you mustn't. You shan't.
Yes, I shan't.
Oh, what have you done? Oh, this is poison. Look what it says on the bottle. If swallowed, will cause convulsion, frizzies, the blahs, ho-hum mouth, and death. Ah, but here's the good part. Contains only 1 calorie.
Am I dead yet?
Compared to what? That's incredible. How come you're still alive?
I couldn't get the cork off. I blow a chance at an Emmy.
I knew it. You're a loser. You can't even commit suicide like a normal person.
Well, here's one suicide that won't fail. I'm gonna walk out in that Pacific Ocean and kill myself until drowned. Before I go, one last kiss. It's a shame I'm going. I still got it. Anyway, this is it. This is goodbye. Les? I'm a little hungry. You got a salami sandwich or anything?
Before you go swimming, you could get cramps.
Yeah, you're right. It's a far, far better thing I do than I have ever done before.
Go already!
Savage.
Oh, why didn't I stop him? Now I'm all alone. What good is success without a loser to share it with? After all, success is only nature's way of telling you you can afford a Mercedes.
Why didn't you tell me we moved to the penthouse? Hey, if you listen real hard, you can hear every attendance record Harris ever had being broken. And the remarkable performer who's doing it is one of the music business's most gifted writing and recording artists. And here he is, a man whose hair won 3 Grammys for curling above and beyond the call of duty. Of course, I can only be talking about Mac Davis.
Now, my friends, a little group called Struts, gonna come out here and help me, and we've doing a song that I wrote about poor boy music, called a poor boy boogie. Well, way down south in a Louisiana bayou, folks don't live like kings. They ain't got style and they ain't got money, but they sure got a song to sing. And long about supper time every day, with the sun going down on the bayou bay, you can hear them poor boys boogieing on, picking and grinning them poor boy songs. Singing, poor boy don't need electronics to make no rock and roll. Poor boy got boogie woogie born right in his soul. Poor boy got rhythm, poor boy got blues. Poor boy got boogie woogie born right in his shoes. City folks don't know what they're missing. They live in an electric world. Son, you ain't lived till you poor boy boogie with a barefoot bayou girl. And down in the bottom at the crawdad hole, the chicken and filet gumbo, you hear them poor boys stomp their feet, dance to the rhythm of the poor boy boogie. Singing, poor boy don't need electronics to make no rock and roll. Poor boy got boogie woogie born right in his soul. Everybody join in. And poor boy don't need electronics, ain't no rock and roll. Poor boy got boogie woogie born right in his soul. Poor boy got rhythm. Poor boy got turkey, I'll sing it as long as I want to.
More laughs in store with Dean Martin and Super Bowl quarterbacks Van Tarkenton and Ken Stabler.
Ever since the automobile was invented, people have searched for ways to get more miles to the gallon. Many ways have been tried, but at Texaco we found long ago that one proven way is regular and thorough car maintenance. That's why Texaco suggests you get your car tuned up regularly using quality Texaco products. Replace worn and dirty spark plugs, install new points, and be sure your timing is adjusted. And don't forget a new clean air filter. Good care can add driving years to your car's life. Today, it makes more sense than ever to depend on your independent Texaco retailer to provide products to help you keep your car running at its best. It still beats any way we know how to get more miles to the gallon. This is Bob Hope for Texaco. We're working to keep your trust.
Say, if you think all motor oil's the same, you're in for a surprise. Watch.
Car 88 responding to call.
This is Bob Hope for Texaco. Recently, more than 40 state trooper cars using Haviland Super Premium all-temperature motor oil were driven a total of over 2 million tough miles. Even though state trooper cars put on more grueling mileage in 6 months than the average car gets in 3 years, there wasn't a single oil-related failure of Haviland protected parts. And of the engines taken apart and inspected, none showed any sign of unusual wear. And with Haviland's formulation, you don't have to buy any extra motor oil additives. To keep your car well protected, change the oil regularly with the one proven by state troopers for over 2 million miles. Haviland Super Premium All-Temperature Motor Oil. Trust Texaco to protect your car like a trooper. Here's a man who has made the word roast a household word, which is kind of strange since he's usually fried. Ladies and gentlemen, a good friend and a great entertainer, Dean Martin.
I've grown accustomed to her face. She almost makes the day begin. I've grown accustomed to the tune she whistles night and noon. Her smiles, her frowns, her ups, her downs are second nature to me now. Like breathing out and breathing in, I was serenely independent and content before we met. Surely I would always be that way again, and yet I've grown accustomed to her looks, accustomed to her voice, so accustomed to her face.
She's second nature to me, like breathing out and breathing in.
I've grown serenely independent and content before we met. Surely I will always be that way again, and yet I've grown accustomed to her looks, accustomed to her voice, so accustomed to that face.
Here are two great stars who made pro football the national addiction it is. They thrilled fans for a lot of years with their exciting, dazzling, heroic play. Ladies and gentlemen, the two Super Bowl quarterbacks, Fran Tarkenton, the Minnesota Vikings, and Kenny Stabler of the Oakland Raiders. Right here. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. Hey, it must be tough to lose those close ones, Fran, huh?
Well, no way we could have won. Somebody stole our Desinex.
What do you think of that?
Yeah, that could do it.
Not only that, but that morning, the kitchen in the hotel ran out of breakfast squares and left me a wreck.
I don't know why you even bothered to show up.
And you won't believe this, but one of the guys forgot to slap Brute on his face.
That's always been a handicap. You believe all this?
Of course. I believe in the tooth fairy, too.
I think he's a little skeptical.
He's cynical. He didn't even believe there'd be a swine flu epidemic. Really, Bob, there's nothing wrong in losing once in a while. As one of our great writers said, It is defeat that makes men invincible.
Oh, that's interesting. Who said that?
Henry Ward Beecher.
Who'd he play for? Tampa Bay?
We couldn't have beaten them either.
Well, that's irrelevant now. Super Bowl 11 is history, and you two guys are among the greatest to ever play the game. Fran, you're really phenomenal. 16 years in the roughest, toughest game of them all, and you still look like the day you started.
I wish that were true, Bob, but when I came out of Georgia, I was 6'4".
Well, what happened?
Well, I ran into Merle Nolson too many times.
Hey, it's a good thing he retired, or you would have been the next Mickey Rooney. But it's your own fault for doing all that scrambling, trying to run for daylight.
Daylight? I was running for my life.
Kenny, it must have given you a special satisfaction to play in the Super Bowl, especially since when you came up, you spent all that time on the bench.
It sure did, Bob. After every game, I wore out a pair of tweezers, removing the splinters.
And Kenny, you and Joe Namath both came out of Alabama, didn't you?
Yeah, but I'll never do it as well as he did.
Why is that?
Well, I don't have the legs for pantyhose.
You two guys are probably the top quarterbacks in the country. I just wondered, is there any animosity between you?
Not an iota. I think Kenny's a true gentleman and a great competitor.
And I think Fran is the epitome of sportsmanship and a wonderful human being.
And I think I'm getting diabetes. Now, that was fun. Now, why don't you tell it like it is?
Okay, Bob. I don't like him at all.
And if he's a quarterback, Otis Sistrunk is Miss America.
Audrey Hepburn knows more about football than he does.
He's done as much for football as Beretta's bird's done for acting.
Hold it, hold it.
Bob, we're just kidding.
I know you are, but you're getting laughs. Fellas, thanks a lot for coming. It's been a kick having you here.
Our pleasure.
Enjoyed it.
There they are, ladies and gentlemen, Fran Tarkenton and Kenny Stabler.
I was young, I never needed anyone, and making love was just for fun. Those days are gone. Living alone, I think of all the friends I've known. But when I dial the telephone, nobody's home. Sometimes I feel so insecure when love, so distant and obscure, remains the cure. All by myself, I don't want to be all by myself anymore. All by I don't want to live all by myself anymore. When I was young, I never needed anyone, and making love was just for fun. Those days are gone. All by myself, I don't want to be all by myself anymore. All by myself, don't want to live all by myself anymore. When I was young, I never needed. Now those days are gone.
fun coming up with Charo, Sammy Davis Jr., and Ann Margaret.
How much does an oil company make on a gallon of gasoline?
30 cents. 30 cents.
Oh, it's got to be at least 50 cents.
A lot. You can bet on that.
10 cents?
We asked people how much they thought an oil company makes on a gallon of gasoline. And very few of them even came close. But that's not surprising. Many people do think oil companies make a lot more than they do. Actually, in the year that ended last June, Texaco made only an average of about 1.25 cents per gallon for all petroleum and products sold. Yes, only 1.25 cents per gallon. What do you think of that?
I never would have guessed that low.
Many people do think we make a lot more, 20, 25, or even 30 cents a gallon, but it's only 1.25 cents. And most of that has to go back into getting you the oil and gasoline you need. At Texaco, we're working to keep your trust.
And now a word from a man who's been one of my favorites for a long time.
You know, you don't have to be a star to have your car treated like one. Texaco thinks every car should be treated like a star with good maintenance and our good gasoline. That's one reason Texaco is America's largest selling gasoline. With our premium Sky Chief, our regular Fire Chief, or lead-free Texaco. All with protective and detergent additives. And remember, star treatment doesn't stop at the gasoline pump. It means regular maintenance and tune-ups with quality Texaco products that will help keep your engine running right so you can get the most out of every gallon of gasoline you use. So if you must drive, have your car maintained regularly and see your independent Texaco retailer for our good gasoline. Oh, now that's what I call star treatment. At Texaco, we're working to keep your trust.
One singular sensation, every little step she takes. One
thrilling combination, every move every makes.
One smile and suddenly nobody else will too.
Oh, you know you'll never be lonely with you.
No,
who?
In her presence, and you can't forget the rest.
All the guys serve the best to know.
Oh, shy, give her your attention. Do I really have to mention?
She's the
one. One. Suddenly nobody else will do.
You know you'll never be lonely.
One moment in her presence and you can't forget the rest.
Oh, for the guys that are best.
That's what I call getting a pair of trunks the hard way.
Hello again, everyone. I'm Howard Cosell, speaking to you from ringside in Veterans Stadium on a freezing, frenetic Friday in fabulous, fantastic Philadelphia. If you'll forgive my adjectival verbiage. An incredible drama is taking shape tonight as Rocky Hipponi, a clumsy, classless, klutzy, claptrap club fighter, gets a once-in-a-lifetime chance at the world title. Against the colorful, climactic, classy, charismatic champion. I mean, champion. Here he comes now. The popular world title holder and poet laureate of Stillman's Gym, Colossus Khalid.
I am strong. I am gorgeous. And as rich as can be. Not only Foreman, but E.F. Hutton listens to me.
Don't you start nothing with this chair now.
Oh, here come the champ. Here come the champ. Here come the champ. Here come the champ. I mean, the champ is here.
You have impeccable taste. That's it. Cut.
It's a little piercing.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Yes, it's him. Here comes the challenger, Rocky Hipponi.
I'd have been here sooner, but I had to drop off a load of cement in Jersey. This is the happiest day for the Italians since Anna Maria got her alberghetti caught in the salad dressing.
Will the contestant step to the center of the ring?
Roses are red and violets are neat. I'm gonna be all over you like prickly heat.
Pepper your eyes with 1,000 blows. By round 13, you'll have to see out of your nose. Oh, you're in big trouble, champ. You're up against the Italian stallion.
That's funny. You look more like the flabby belly from mozzarella to me.
Who
is that?
It's me. Rocky's kind-hearted, but not too good-looking girlfriend, Angie.
Angie, I thought I told you to wait in the car.
I've been there since 1972. It's very stuffy in the trunk.
Can we get on with this massacre, you jive box?
What do you want, Angie?
Oh, Rocky, I want to kiss you for good luck.
Oh, boy, that's all I need, a 1-2 combination. His fist and your nose.
Ask you something. 10,000 chicks in Philadelphia. How'd you get stuck with Danny Thomas?
Oh, Rocky, I love you. Ever since the day you came into the pet shop to get a dog and walked out with me.
Let me rephrase that.
Yeah. Oh, Rocky, kiss me for luck.
Okay, but first, wait a minute. Hey. You know something, Angie? Without your nose, you ain't half bad looking.
Oh, Rocky, now can I take yours off?
Lady, plain lady, don't you worry about taking his nose off, because I'm gonna do that myself. And I also may break his hair just for good luck. Because I am, I repeat, I am. The fabulous.
All right. Come on over here. Now, you both know the rules. No elbows. And no rub
rabbit punches. And no kidney punches either.
I can't wait till the fight starts so I can get a little rest.
You don't have to worry about me, Reverendo. I don't need none of them elbows, them rabbits, or them kidneys. Dig on what I'm gonna lay on you. Bruce, check it.
Lucky punch.
All right. Now, go to your neutral corners.
All right, and then.
Where are you going? Where are you going?
I'm going to Switzerland.
But why Switzerland?
The whole country's in a neutral corner over there. Did you see what he did to those two guys? Huh? That Jewish kid is small, but he's wiry.
All to stop right here now. I'm not gonna let you all stand here and destroy the name of me and my profession. Not gonna do it.
What do you mean, boxing?
No, acting.
First and second.
Let me tell you something else too. All of you people out there in television land, I just cut a movie. Me, I just did a movie with Columbia Pictures, a $6 million budget. I played myself. You will see the man you thought you knew. I want you all to come see that movie.
You got
movie.
Any tickets on you? How about some tickets?
Never mind him. I'm a brother. Give me some.
Ladies and gentlemen, Charles.
In Jujillar de Don Fernando, I remember long ago, another starry night like this. In the firelight, Fernando, you were humming to yourself and softly playing your guitar. I could hear the distant drums and sound of bugle calls were coming from afar. They were close now, Fernando. Every hour, every minute seemed to last eternally. I was so afraid, Fernando. We were young and full of life, and none of us prepared to die. And I'm not ashamed to say the roar of guns and cannon almost made me cry. There was something in the air that night. Now we're all angry, Fernando. Since many years I haven't seen a rifle in your hand. Can you hear the drum, Fernando? Do you still recall the fateful night we crossed the Rio Grande? I can see it in your eyes, how proud you were to fight for freedom in this land. There is something in the
I'm
you, Charo. Magnificent as usual.
Thank you, Bob. You know, I'm really very excited to be in your show.
Are you?
And I had what you call a goose hump all over me. Yeah.
That's what they listen, are. Anyway.
Listen, how come this is the first time this year I have been on your show? What took you so long for bringing me to your show?
Well, you're always moving, Charo. I had to wait till you came to a stop. You're dynamite. You take vitamins?
No, vitamin take me. I love it.
Boy, you really get out of neutral, aren't you? You make Tom Jones look like Perry Como.
Oh, but Hope, you are exaggerating.
Well, watching you is an adventure, I'll tell you that. When you get going, you got more parts moving at once than the bionic woman with her puka shells caught in a blender.
The bionic woman! Hey, all my part at my own.
Yeah, well, we wouldn't have it any other way, I'll tell you. No, Charo, you have so much vitality. You're always so dynamic. How can you keep it up?
That is a good question. You know, por la mañana cuando yo me levanto, yo me tomo un zumo de limón con agua bien caliente y después corro y digo arriba. Y después doy muchas vueltas donde la gente me dice qué está haciendo. Yo digo lo que me da la gana y doy 200 vueltas a la manzana.
Sure, that's easy for you to say. What does that mean?
It means that if you got it, you use it.
You know what worries me? I'm beginning to understand her.
Do you speak Spanish?
Oh, fluently. Get this. Taco, burrito, enchilado, and refried beans.
And what did that mean?
I don't know. They came with my Cordoba. By the way, Charo, you're a real show business success story. A little girl from Spain.
Yes.
Came to this country. Who came to this country with only a suitcase, a couple of hoochie-coochies, and a brrrr. And now you're a giant star.
Yeah. When I first came to America, I stood in front of the Statue of Liberty. And I saw the word that were to change my whole life.
Yeah, do you remember what it said?
Oh, yes. I never forget it. It say, for a good time, call Cougar 555-2929.
Show still to come with Matt Davis, Dean Martin, and Sammy Davis Jr.
Once upon a time, there were two drivers. The not-so-smart driver who got terrible gasoline mileage because he never took care of himself. And the smart driver who got great mileage because he'd see his wise friend, his independent Texaco retailer, for regular maintenance. He'd check under his hood, tune him up. He'd check him out, even take him for a test ride. His friend got him in great shape for great mileage. Now the not-so-smart driver never ran right. He sensed he needed a tune-up, because he was eating up fuel. He'd idle rough, misfire, even stall. Finally, he conked out where there wasn't a friend in sight. Our moral? Don't be a dumb bunny. Be a smart driver. Get better gasoline mileage and save money and trouble. See your independent Texaco retailer.
Hey, did you ever play Follow the Leader? Well, here's one time it makes a lot of sense. Watch.
Today, millions of people are protecting their cars like a trooper with a motor oil that has a very large following. Texaco's Haviland Super Premium. People have learned to trust the motor oil that's been tested in more than 40 state trooper cars and driven a total of over 2 million grueling miles. Of the engines taken apart and inspected, there were no signs of unusual wear. No matter what kind of buggy you're driving, come on, follow me. Join the millions of Haviland users on the road today.
See, I'm beginning to feel like the Pied Piper. So next time you need oil,
See your independent Texaco retailer for Haviland Super Premium Motor Oil.
And remember, with Haviland's formulation, you don't have to buy any extra motor oil additives. It provides all the protection a car's engine needs.
So get Texaco's Haviland Super Premium Motor Oil and protect your car like a trooper.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mac Davis. Well, Mac, let me tell you, it's great to have you on the show.
Well, it's a big thrill for a little old farm boy like me to get to work with a big star like you.
Oh, don't give me that. You're no little old farm boy. You've been so successful, you've got the only pigs that eat fillet of slop.
That's not true. It's only half fillet mixed with two boxes of slop helper.
Hey, what do you think of Lake Tahoe, Mac?
Well, it's really beautiful up here, and the air is so pure.
I know, and they're trying to keep it that way. No one from L.A. is allowed to exhale.
By the way, aren't you from Georgia? Well, you might say that. I was born in Texas, but I was raised in Atlanta. You know that little village just outside of Plains, Georgia?
You've really come a long way since those early days in Atlanta, huh?
Yeah, it seems like only yesterday I was picking cotton. Matter of fact, yesterday I was picking cotton.
Me too. My biggest kick is opening new aspirin bottles.
Look, how was it when you started in vaudeville, Bob?
Oh, boy, I got hit in the face with so many tomatoes and zucchinis, they were billing me as a human Vegematic. I had the only nose that could slice, dice, and peel a potato in flight. But those rough days were worth it just to be in show business, don't you think?
Yeah, they sure were. That's why I'm always singing. I believe in music. And I also believe in love, Bob. How about you?
Oh, I believe in it, but at my age, that's about as far as it goes. That's why I'm always singing Thanks for the Memory. Mac, how about singing one of your songs for us now?
Well, all right. I guess it's about time I stopped admiring your suit and got to work.
Sing, Harpo.
Every now and then, a blind squirrel finds an acorn. And every now and then, a crippled sparrow takes to the wind. Lately, that's what keeps me going. I find comfort just in knowing that it happens every now and then. Every now and then, a seeker finds the answers. Every now and then, a loser learns how to win. Well, I believe that some sweet evening, I'll find someone to believe in. I know it happens every now and then. Sun shines when it's raining. And every now and then, a down and outer finds a true friend. Sure as there's a Lord above me, I know someday someone's gonna love me. I know it happens every now and then. God, it happens every now and then.
Good evening from Washington, D.C. At the inauguration party, this is award-winning newsman and hairstylist for Tom Snyder, Mr. Sander Van Johnson.
And I'm Nancy Dickerson.
It is a gala and festive evening here in our nation's capital with 300,000 people. I don't have to tell you that the sound of peanuts crunching is deafening.
And no expense has been spared in the catering of this gigantic affair. From our vantage point, we can actually see the banquet table. And on that table is a giant jello mold, I think. Yes, a giant jello mold shaped in the likeness of Billy Carter.
No, correction. That is Billy Carter leaning in the jello mold.
Well, in any event, he appears to be having a wonderful time. But wait a minute. There's a little excitement at the banquet table. It looks like, while leaning over to interview the president's brother, Barbara Walters got too up close and personal. Seems that her crown fell off, and it seems to be causing Brother Billy a great deal of pain.
Film at 11. It is a warm and jovial affair this evening, a no hard feelings affair, if you will, because the former president's entire cabinet is here in force, and a darn good job they're doing, too,
carrying
around those trays of hors d'oeuvres and emptying ashtrays. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is any town, USA.
I wonder, Sandy Van, if the viewers know that no hard liquor is being served at this particular gala evening.
Yes, but for those who really crave alcohol, Dean Martin has slumped over a security guard in the overroom, and those who wish to imbibe are being allowed to file by and sniff his bow tie.
Wait, hold it. Hold it just a moment, ladies and gentlemen. Just wait a minute, if you will. There's a wave of excitement building up. Yes, building up right here at the ball. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment that we've all been waiting for, the arrival of the president and the first lady, as Charlton Heston precedes them, waving his staff to part the crowds.
Yes, and the president is smiling broadly as he accepts the congratulations of the Democrats and the job resumes of the Republicans.
What a gala evening this is. And so, ladies and gentlemen, as Amy Carter quietly pours lemonade on a Secret Service man, we leave colorful Washington on this most memorable night.
Yes, and it's interesting to note in closing that the president has kept the first of his campaign promises. He has given Fritz Mondale an important responsibility. The vice president's carrying Jimmy Carter's garment bag. Where else but in a free America?
Good night, Sandy Van.
Good night, Nancy.
In the early days of yesteryear, there were but a handful of men who dared to explore the wild and unknown wilderness of uncharted lands. This is the story of two such brave and crusty explorers.
I am Lewis Brave.
And I'm Clark Crusty.
Oh, this is the worst 4th of July I've ever seen.
There ain't gonna be much fun with our firecrackers all soggy.
We're off on the road to Lake Tahoe in search of adventure and truth. For 2 years now we've slished and sloshed to find it, goodness knows. Someday soon we're coming back
to try to find our toes.
We certainly do get around. Like Ricardo's dictionary, we are Monto Bound.
Everybody's a critic.
This is a good day. If this weather gets any worse, I'll have to put snow chains on my tongue.
My lips are so blue, I could sell them to tourists for turquoise jewelry.
If you're taking orders, put me down for a slave bracelet.
Hey, we gotta stop complaining. We've had a mission. We've been destined to discover a new land where free men can swim, hunt, ski, and sit in front of slot machines with a paper cup. That's what it's all about, isn't it?
Not for me. I just answered an ad in Swingers Quarterly. Wanted guy who gets turned on by beaverline mucklucks. No weirdos or fatties, please.
All right. Okay.
So I lied about the fatties.
And you're one.
I'm so hungry that the snow is beginning to taste good.
Yeah, but it's not filling. An hour later, you get an irresistible urge for slush foo young. Hey, when's the last time we ate?
Oh, last Thanksgiving on the desert. Yeah, we had prime rib of cactus, cactus salad, and cactus pie. I had so many holes in me, one drink, and I could have got to work as a sprinkler.
Well, it sure beats our Christmas dinner. Hush puppies. For 2 weeks, the laces kept getting stuck in my teeth. Oh, boy. That's some strong wind.
You're telling me, when we started out this morning, your nose was straight.
And it's getting colder every minute. Last night, I bent over to tie my shoelaces and broke my shorts. Boy, is there any food left? I'm getting hungrier by the minute.
You think you're hungry? Look at this poor guy. He's famished.
Looks like a Weight Watcher who forgot to say when.
I gotta have food, you hear? Food, that's what I gotta have.
Take it easy now.
No, but I got...
Take it easy.
The only thing that keeps me going is that date I had last night with that beautiful girl.
Boy, you really have flipped. That was a caribou.
It was. I hope she mails my ring back.
How could you give her your ring? She's engaged to me.
And after I took her to Tiffany's and bought her an engraved compost pile... It's a woman.
Moon of manicure, the field.
Hey, that's no woman.
That's a mirage.
A mirage? Mm-hmm. What's that?
That is what you see ain't what you get.
Yeah. I don't care if it is a mirage. She's mine.
We'll see.
Man, I wonder if it's too late to call the caribou. Guess what happens when your travel agent turns out to be Texaco?
Hey, this is Bob for Texaco Hope. You know, while Crosby's been squeezing oranges, I've been going places where Texaco's squeezing more oil out of our dwindling supplies. Like Santa Maria, California, where Texaco's getting more oil out than before by heating it with steam. Down a make-believe oil well.
Yes, looks like the place. We've reached oil. You know, it might take Texaco as long as a year and a half to drill a real well and go down 4 miles and spend over $1 million.
Then I played around near a big water hole. A Texaco rig 70 miles out in the Gulf of Mexico, in water 260 feet deep, where drilling can cost up to 6 times more than on land. Yeah, I've seen Texaco do the whole job to get you the oil and gasoline you need. At Texaco, we're working to keep your trust.
Hey, you want to save some money on an oil change? Here's how.
Hi, Bill. It's a lot of Havilland.
Oh, that's for my oil change special, Mr. O'Connor. 5 quarts of Havilland Super Premium, the oil that protects your car like a trooper, plus a Texaco oil filter. Install. And you won't believe the price.
I won't believe it?
I'm telling you, Mr. O'Connor, you won't believe it.
Now's the perfect time to change your oil.
Just come to your participating Texaco retailer for his oil and filter change special. You won't believe the price.
Bill, would you believe I need an oil change?
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we'd like to do a number we've been dying to do for
Robert,
a long time.
Robert, I hate to interrupt you, but I was wondering if we could do something together, because it seems that when we do something together, the audience likes it. I get a lot of letters. You know, even on your show, when you did The Best of Bob Hope, you had a number with you and I dancing and singing together, and I thought we could do something really heavy.
Listen, Sam, I happen to know that you've worked almost every day without a vacation for the last 2 years. Why don't you do something just to relax?
Relax?
Yeah.
How do you do that, Bob?
Sand.
No. See, I'm not too big with sand because it gets in my hair and messes up my dude, and I gotta pick it out. You know, with the grease, it didn't matter, but now that we're going natural. I mean, I ain't gonna lie on the sand.
Sam, I know it's getting down to the nitty-gritty, but I think... Here's what I mean, Sam. Look, Sam. You just... dance on it like that.
Oh, I dig where you're coming
from. You with it? Yeah. Cool.
I was born in Amsterdam, that is why they call me Sammy.
I was born across the sea, and even then they laughed at me.
It's yours.
Yeah. Eat them up. Hey! Hey!
From beautiful Lake Tahoe, home of the Tahoe Tacky Film Festival, we present the Bob Hope Roast with Charo. Red Button. And here's our Roast Master of Ceremonies, Bob Hope.
Say, tonight we're honoring a giant entertainer, a personality who towers high above the rest of us and has the magical ability to hold an audience in the palm of his hand. Ladies and gentlemen, our honored guest, King Kong. How'd you like to buy a right guard for that? You'd have to buy it by the drum. You have to do what? But where did it all begin, this saga of a super simian, this monkey with a gland condition, this chimp turned blimp? It all started back in 1933. There you were, Kong, in Midtown Manhattan, high atop the Empire State Building. And then the police started coming and the plane started shooting at you. And through all of this, you were giving Fay Wray a back rub she'll never forget. And now here it is, 1977. Only this time you're straddling the World Trade Center. Again, the airplanes and helicopters shoot you down and you fall, landing on a 6'7" man, squashing him to 3'3". And that man today is Mayor Abe Beam. And so, Kong, you Goodyear gorilla, you, some of the greatest celebrities in Hollywood are here this night to pay tribute to you. Down, boy. I think he ate a village that didn't agree with him.
Our first guest is that fascinating bombshell Charo. She got the most successful catchphrase in show business. Every time she goes coochie coochie, she gets a gift from Poochie and Gucci. Let's hear it for Charo.
Thank you so much. Muchas gracias. Thank you. Muchas gracias. Muchas gracias. And thank you very much, Mr. Bob Hype.
That's hope.
That is not what you've been trying to do with me all night.
I remember that. I gotta check with my doctor.
Hello. Hello, Kong. You monkey around? He must be very rich. You must be very rich, my goodness. He got wall-to-wall a fur coat. Hey, what do you want to say? After the show, would you like to go with me dancing? I'm going to teach you how to do the funky chicken. The funky chicken. The funky chicken? What did he say?
He say, if you don't stop doing the funky chicken, you're going to end up with a very funky monkey.
Okay, see you later.
Thank you, Joe. Thank you, honey. Thank you, darling. That's her, the greatest. She's the greatest. Charo, the greatest shake since the San Andreas fault. Our next guest was supposed to be Sammy Davis Jr., but unfortunately, he couldn't make it. He was pinned to his bed by body jewelry. But be sure to see his upcoming TV series, The $6 Million Dwarf. Our next guest is Red Buttons. Actually, that's not his real name. His real name is Blue Zipper. But he had to change it to go into show business. I mean, how would it look in a marquee? Blue Zipper opens tonight? Ladies and gentlemen, Red Buttons, right here.
Thank you. Thank you, Bob. Thank you. Thank you, Bob. Thank you. I'm not here to pay tribute to this overstuffed orangutan. Yes, I mean you, you bloated baboon. Why should we give King Kong a dinner when some of the greatest animals in the history of the world never got a dinner? Never. Bambi, who said, if I see one more stag movie, I'll scream, never got a dinner. Trigger, who once said to Roy Rogers, get off my back, never got a dinner. Cheetah the chimp, who said to Jane, now that Tarzan's out of town, I'll show you why I'm called Cheetah. Got a dinner. The dragon who said to St. George, flick it a bick. Never got a dinner. Mickey Mouse who said to James Cagney, who are you calling a dirty rat? Never got a the snake who said to Eve in the Garden of Eden, how do you like them apples? Never got a dinner. The shark from Jaws who said, do you want to see me do my Jimmy Carter impression? Never got a dinner. Well, I better get out of here or I'll be the dinner. I'll see you later.
Through with Kong?
I guess so. He's through with us, I think.
We're going over to my house and drink the pool.
Like all the movies we've kidded tonight, this trip to Lake Tahoe, thanks to Bill Hara, has been for me another script with a happy ending. You know, I've been traveling all my life, and I've seen many of the most beautiful places in the world. But this week, while I was watching Tahoe's first snowfall of the year blanket those majestic mountains, it made me especially proud to be a part of America.
and hopefully contributing to it some of the laughter and happiness that brings us all closer together. This is President Jimmy Carter's first day in office, and yesterday, for the 38th time in history, we witnessed the exchange of powers of the greatest country on earth. In only a couple of months, we fought our verbal battles, mended our scars, and rallied behind the man who will be doing his best to successfully lead us through our problems and crises for the next 4 years. Makes me realize just how beautiful this country really is, not only on the outside, but on the inside as well. Thank you. God bless you and good night.
Texaco's been proud to present Bob Hope's All-Star Comedy Spectacular from Lake Tahoe. We hope you had a good time. And remember, visit your independent Texaco retailer who has quality gasoline for your car and can help keep it running in top shape with fine quality Texaco products. At Texaco, we're working to keep your trust. Also appearing in tonight's cast, Eddie Marr. This is John Harlan speaking.